protect themselves in the exit process? Can an employee refuse to sign a severance agreement? And if they do so, what are the ramifications for them?
Yeah, so I think the issue when you're counseling an employee, I mean, obviously, you know, when they've just been terminated or laid off, and there's severance being offered, and assuming that's been negotiated to the point where it's acceptable, you know, there's not a lot of employees that are just going to walk away from that. So really the question that constantly arises in our practice is, you know, the employee asks, well, you know, there appears to be provisions in here that I might run afoul of if I wanted to go to a regulator, and you know, usually this would be under Dodd-Frank. So when we've been seeing, without having the carve-out clause that I just talked about, when we see confidentiality, non-disparagement, other clauses that and especially, as I flagged, return of document clauses that may technically be breached if the employer were to go to a regulator like the SEC, you know, the question is what do they do? Is there some risk there? And if so, is the employee willing to take it in return for getting the severance payment that they probably need to move on with their life? And I think some of these answers, you know, some of these have been answered in terms of the SEC guidance and the enforcement issues. But, you know, particularly with this return of document clause, I think it remains, at least technically, an open issue.